at a formal level, we have been successful in that we have established a multi-party system based on free, fair and regular elections. And this is a major achievement of independence. If you look around us at Pakistan, at Bangladesh, at Nepal, at the African countries, we are, India and Sri Lanka are the only two ex-colonial countries in Asia and Africa that for the entire period of their independence have regularly held free, fair elections. And elections in India, though now there are some unfortunate accusations about EVM tampering, by and large they are fair. And by and large they are not lost. And this is the, and though money plays a part, the richest party can lose, as happened in Delhi in 1975, last time, Aam Aadmi Party, as happened in 1977 after the emergency, as has happened in many states, for example, when the Dravidian parties first beat the Congress in 1967, they did not have the money, and so on and so forth. So elections, free, fair and regular elections, are an important achievement of independence. But other aspects of our democracy are less robust. For example, Parliament hardly functions. And this was not always the case. If you look at the debates in the 50s and 60s and 70s, they were very vocal, very honest. Now, no one wants to discuss what happened. And state assemblies function even less. So, elections are only are a major aspect of democracy, but they are not the sole aspect of democracy. We are in danger of being reduced to what I call an elections only democracy. The election is free and fair. So there will be an election in Maharashtra in 3 years' time, and the ruling party can't doctor or fix it. But so let's assume they lose, and the Congress comes back to power in 2020. Between 2020 and 2025, there will be no discussion, no parliament, no debate. So, jo bhi karna hai karo 5 saal mein. So, what I am calling elections, so not only the parliament, the bureaucracy, the police, they should also be impartial. The press, now they are increasing terms from the press. In between elections, you have to sign that democracy means you win an election that gives you the right to be in power for 5 years. But that does not give you the right to be immune from criticism for 5 years. In fact, a healthy democracy, you will govern better if you get healthy criticism. But who will sign a minute to you? The Vidhan Sabha is not meeting. The bureaucrats can't give you honest advice because they will be transferred if they give you honest advice. Right. The press you want to control. If they are critical of you, you will withdraw advertising. Or you will start a tax case against the proprietor. Now this is a real weakness of all. So I mean, our writers are being killed, you know, and so on. So this is a deep flaw in our democracy. That we are in danger of being reduced to an election, what I call an elections only democracy. In, by all means, elections are crucial, multi-party competition is vital. But for the period a lawfully elected government is in power, they cannot position themselves above it.